Hey guys, how are you all? Maybe I'll leave the acting to the students. They're much better at that. Welcome, my name is Greg Roush and I'm the principal at Westridge Elementary School. Wow, we're entering our fourth year in the productions at Westridge Elementary School where our students and teachers and community have worked just tremendously hard to put together another wonderful, wonderful play. This year is bittersweet to me for several reasons. But this year you're going to get a chance to see Disney's Little Mermaid Jr., in which students began casting in November and December, started practicing in January through April, and then put on three fabulous sell-out performances of the Little Mermaid. Once again, the performances and the singing and the acting was just phenomenal, and I can't tell you how proud I am of our students and our staff and our community for working together so wonderfully to put on such a wonderful, wonderful play. This year, bittersweet to me, as I have accepted the position at Central Office, and I won't have the opportunity to be a part of the play like I have in the past and just watching the productions. But I hope that in the future, community and the staff will continue to work hard together to continue putting on such wonderful plays. See that our students are extending on into Bondurant, and this is the second time we've had students go on to Bondurant Middle School but return back to Westridge to be a part of our play. Maybe in the future we can continue that and involve more students in the community and more students at our middle school. So I hope you enjoy the show. Sit back and enjoy the Disney's Little Mermaid Jr. Thank you.
Might that be?
Your youngest, such a voice, that child. Notes as clear as ice.
He just threw us water. Well, I haven't heard such magnificent sounds since the Queen.
May she rest in peace.
Oh, you're gonna be so proud. If only that girl would show up for rehearsals once in a while.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let the festivities begin!
Pick up a dingle hopper, just like so. Sure thing, kid. And I ain't just blowing smoke. It makes music the likes of which you never heard.
Music? Oh, no. The concert. My father's gonna kill me.
The concert was today?
I completely forgot. Come on, Flounder. Thank you, Scuttle.
Anytime, sweets. Anytime.
My pets, Jetsam, my darling, come to me, my little sea spies. Mama's feeling woe begone, banished to the nether regions of the sea. No food, hardly any company. I'm simply wasting away.
Poor Ursula.
Yes, poor me. What news do you have?
King Triton the Muffler got celebrating your defeat, and he blames you for the queen's demise.
Of course he does. Use a little black magic to help out a few merfolk, and this is the thanks I get. Well, now it's time to turn the tides on Triton. We just need to find his Achilles heel, a weakness that will crack his armor.
The king is terribly devoted to his daughters, especially the youngest one with the beautiful voice. But she missed the celebration.
Apparently, Ariel takes her gift for granted, just like her mother did. A woman doesn't know how precious her voice is until she's been silenced. You two find out what that girl really wants and lure her here to my lair. I'll whip up a little spell to make all of her dreams come true. And once we have her trapped, Triton will rush to her rescue. And then, my dears?
Yes?
The Triton, crown, and throne will all be mine!
Daddy, I know.
It wasn't even Ariel's fault. We could have come straight away, but then the seagull started going on and on about human stuff.
Seagull? Human stuff? You went up to the surface!
Nothing happened.
You could have been seen by one of those barbarians!
Daddy, they're not barbarians!
They're dangerous. Nets, harpoons, you're my youngest!
I'm old enough to take after myself!
As long as you live under my reef, you'll obey my rules!
If you just listen to me for one!
That's the last time you're ever swimming to the surface! Again, understood?
You're so unfair!
Ugh! Ugh, she's stubborn as a barnacle.
Teenagers, give them an inch and they swim all over you.
I can govern a kingdom, but I can't control my own daughter. Maybe I was too harsh.
Nonsense, sire! If you ask me, you haven't been tough enough.
I haven't.
Ariel needs constant supervision. Someone to watch over her, to keep her out of trouble.
That's not a bad idea.
I'd say it's a right good one.
And you are just the crab to do it.
What?
You heard me. From now on, Ariel is your responsibility.
Mine? But your majesty, she is a clever mermaid. And I am just a crustacean. Surely you ought to pick someone higher on the evolutionary ladder.
I just don't see a world that makes such wonderful things could be so bad.
Wouldn't you think I'm the girl who has everything? I've got gadgets and gizmos aplenty. I've got who's its and what's its galore.
You want thingamabobs? I've got 20.
But who cares? No big deal. I want more. I want to be where the people are. I want to see Wanna see them dancing, walking around on those, what do you call them? Oh, feet. Flipping your fins, you don't get too far. Legs are required for jumping, dancing, strolling along down the, what's that word again? Street. Up where they walk, up where they run, up where they stand in the sun, wandering free. Wish I could be part of that world. What would I give if I could live out of these waters? What would I pay to spend a day warm on this sand? Bet you on land they understand. Bet they don't reprimand their daughters. Bright young women, sick of swimming, ready.
Trouble in the mind.
Sebastian! What is all this?
Just a few knickknacks I've collected, that's all.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself if your poor father knew about this deed.
Oh, please, Sebastian, you're not gonna tell him, are you? Oh, please, he'd never understand.
Ariel, down here is your home. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got from there.
We want the love.
That's what I'm talking about. Ariel, hello? Oh, somebody got to nail that girl's fins to this floor.
Did you ever try to take your princess sailing? It's a joke. Their dresses get caught in the rigging, and most of them can't even swim.
You know, there's more to the woman than a thumb to kick. Our king needs a queen.
Where am I going to find her, Grimsby? A girl who's as carefree and alive as the sea itself. Where? There's too much to hope for, isn't it? Somewhere out there, a girl who's a match for a guy like me.
Perhaps you're not looking hard enough.
I've never seen a human this close before.
Me neither!
Shh! I thought you were an expert.
Stop!
Sure.
Yikes! Excitable! Hideous, ain't it?
I don't know, Scuttle. I think he's really handsome.
Trust me, Grimsby. When I come across the girl of my dreams, it'll hit me like lightning.
Took a terrible tumble.
That voice, I can't get it out of my head.
Come with me, and a night of sleep you'll be as good as new.
I have to find her and thank her for saving my life.
You've heard too many tall tales.
No, she was real.
Sure she was. As real as a mermaid on the rocks.
I don't know when, I don't know how, but I know something's starting right now.
Water on the brain, what has got her?
Love? My little Ariel? So that explains it. Just a minute there, Flounder.
Who? Me?
You know Ariel as well as anybody. Who's the lucky merman?
Gee, I didn't even know it was love until the second chorus.
Sebastian, any ideas?
I tried to stop her, sire, but she doesn't listen. I tell her, Ariel, you've got to stay away from those humans. They are nothing but trouble.
Humans? What about humans? Sebastian, have you been keeping secrets from me? Where is that girl?
And now, let me see. What did Scuttle call this one? A ditty wumper? A thumb doodle? Whatever it is, Prince Eric held it in his own strong, beautiful human hands. Ariel? What is all this?
Daddy, they're my
human junk.
No, treasures.
Did you save a human from drowning?
He would have died.
That savage brute could have killed you, and it's my job to keep you safe from harm.
He didn't frighten me. He made me feel wonderful. Besides, I'm not a child anymore.
No? Well, you're sure talking like one. He's a human. You're a mermaid.
It doesn't matter. I wish Mother were here.
Ariel, I miss your mother just as much as you do, but I'm still the king, and you are not to go to the surface ever again. Am I clear? I'm just trying to protect her, Sebastian.
She'll be all right, sire. Just give her some time.
I hate him.
Ariel, don't say.
Is some friend you turned out to be spilling everything?
I couldn't help it. He had my claws in a clamp.
I don't need you. I don't need any of you. Go away. I said go away. I don't belong here. If only I could be up there.
Poor, sweet, misunderstood child. She has a very serious problem, hasn't she? Who will ease her woes and worries?
Who will help her get her mad?
Perhaps the sea witch can.
Who are? How did you?
She's been dying to meet you.
Ursula, help me?
Of course, but she can't leave her lair.
Then take me to her.
Of course.
Did you have a visitor?
I don't know if...
Now, mustn't get cold fins.
Don't be shy, Ariel, darling. I shouldn't be here. Mother died because of you.
Oh, child. What happened to your mother was an unfortunate accident.
An accident?
Of course! I did my very best to save her.
But Father told me...
The truth is that the ocean wasn't big enough for your father and me, so he sent me here. And I see that he's driven you away, too.
He doesn't understand me.
Oh, but I do, dumpling. We're so very alike. You and I, gals with ambition. Now tell me absolutely everything.
I'm in love with someone. A human.
A prince, I hear. Quite a catch. Well, then it's so simple. You've got to become a human yourself.
Can you do that?
My dear, sweet child. It's what I live for. To help unfortunate merfolk like yourself. Poor souls with no one else to turn to. I admit that in the past I've been a nasty. They weren't kidding when they called me, well, a witch. But you'll find that nowadays, I've mended all my ways. Repented, seen the light, and made a switch. True, yes. And I fortunately know a little magic. It's a talent that I always have possessed. Enter lately, please don't laugh. I use it on behalf of the miserable, lonely, and depressed. Pathetic, poor, unfortunate souls. I help them?
Yes, indeed.
Those poor, unfortunate souls.
It's sad.
They come flocking to my call and crying, spare Ursa, please, and I help them. Yes, I do. Now it's happened once or twice. Someone couldn't pay the price, and I'm afraid I had to rake across the coals. Yes, I've had the odd complaint, but on the whole, I've been. to those poor unfortunate souls. I had a spell that will turn you into human for 3 days. Before the sun sets on the 3rd day, you've got to give dear old Princey to kiss you. And if you do, you'll stay human forever.
But if I don't?
You'll turn back into a mermaid and your soul will be mine forever. Life's full of dumb choices, isn't it? Of course, there is one more thing. My fee.
But I don't have any.
I'm not asking for much. Only your voice.
But if I give away my voice, how would I ever talk or speak or do anything?
You'll have your looks, your pretty face, and don't underestimate the importance of body language. Come on, you poor unfortunate soul. Go ahead, make your choice. I'm a very busy woman and I haven't got all day. It won't cost much, just your voice. You poor unfortunate soul. It's sad, but true. If you want to cross the bridge, my sweet, you've got to pay the toll. Take a gulp and take a breath and go ahead, achieve your goal. Flotsam jetsam, now I've got a voice. The boss is on a roll. You poor unfortunate soul.
Took you for someone else. What is it? You're hurt?
No. You need help?
Well, I've got just a remedy. A warm bath and a hot meal. Come on now. The palace isn't far.
Wake up, Ariel. And that's what I call real little man.
Oh, now I've got to follow them. This is gonna get me in real hot water.
Can you believe that guy? What a crab.
Hey,
everyone attention. Le menu, Fossisaur, Escargo. Lobster bisque, tuna tartare, holy mackerel, made to know.
Over the wall, under the gutter, in through the window. Now finally, someplace I'm safe.
Uh-oh. Le... What? Soley bonbon, how I love the bonbon. Love to jump to serve little fish. First I cut off their head, then I cut the bones down. Maybe c'était déjà, did it? Le bonbon, ha ha ha. With the cleaver I hack them in two. I pull out the one side and I serve it fried. Gosh, I love little fishes, don't you?
Here's something for tempting of the palate. Prepare the classic technique.
Virtual foulness is flung with the mallet.
Then you slash through the skin, give the belly a slice, then you rub some sun in.
Now I'm the one who speaks.
It's been a long time since we've dined in the company of such loveliness.
Usually it's just me and Grim. You have to stare across the table at my ugly mug.
The bath certainly worked its wonders. Your mystery guest is groom for groom, you might say.
Easy, old boy, easy. She's got no voice.
Oh dear.
My, isn't that unusual? Thank you.
Don't tell me she's fond of pipes. Can't say I blame you. That's an antique from Dusseldorf.
Sorry, old friend, but it looks like your pipe smoked you.
Very amusing, yes. Well, she knows how to make you smile.
You should see some of the princesses Grimsby drags in for dinner. So prim, so boring. But you. So, if you don't mind my asking, what was it? An accident when you were small? I'm sorry, I didn't mean... Who needs words anyway? A smile says just as much sometimes. Why? You're nimble on your feet, aren't you? Well, dancing beats small talk any day. It's the way you like smile or laugh. It can let you say so many things. Dancing is a language that is felt instead of heard. You can whisper, sing, or shout without so much as a word. Try it, go on, like so. Just let your emotions tell your body what to do. See how much a single gesture can reveal. So every single step, every little step is one step closer to saying what you feel. Thank you. It's been haunting me. Anyway, I had to let you get some sleep. Good night.
Out of the frying pan, into the fire. The things I do for you, young lady. Now I should march you right back home to your father.
So you can be miserable the rest of your life. It's true, I've got no backbone.
All right, child, I mean, but we got to get that boy to kiss you before it's too late. Now, a few pointers from a clever crab to a little mermaid. You got to bat your eyes like this. You got to poke your lips like this. Oh, that's good. You do that tomorrow and you got the boy in the palm of your hand.
No girls ever dared to join me out here before. Too afraid they'd muddy their shoes. But not you. Peaceful, isn't it? Not another living soul for miles and miles. If only.
Hey guys, what's happening?
Nothing is happening! Shh!
They spent all morning on horseback, then an afternoon picnic. Now this, and not so much as a peck on the cheek.
But we only have one day left.
So how about this weather?
We got to do something, and quick.
But what?
We got to create the right kind of mood.
Oh, even like candlelight and champagne.
Nonsense. It don't take all that. Everything we need, we got right here. Percussion. String. Wind. And work.
Win! Send to
set and your birthday is almost over. You must choose a mate.
Ariel?
For heaven's sake, child.
Quiet, Grigsby. Go on, Ariel.
So hoped you would find love somewhere in this room.
I have, Grimsby. I've just been too blind to see it before. Come here, Ariel.
Can it be another contestant?
That's the voice, but tell her the contest's already over. I've made it.
You might be here. I've come to apologize.
Most merciful Triton.
Sebastian, where have you been and where is Ariel?
Oh, she'd be so angry if she knew I was here.
I entrust my youngest daughter to you, and what happens? She disappears. I ought to have you cracked and shelled.
He almost was your greatness.
What kind of tragedy will it take?
Tragedy involving the sea witch.
What?
Don't be a guppy. Don't be gubby. Ariel traded her voice to the sea witch to become human, and she's got 3 days to make Prince Eric fall in love with her.
She bartered away her voice to become human?
And now that girl has given up her very soul.
Oh, Ariel, what have you done? Come, we must save my daughter.
Say goodbye to your prince. You're mine now, Little Mermaid. Get ready to spend the rest of your days as my slave.
Ursula!
King Triton! You're right on cue. What have you done to my daughter?
Nothing! She's done it all to herself, trading her voice away. And for what? Human heartbreak.
Give her back to me!
Not on your life. It so happens that your daughter made a bargain.
No!
Swapped her voice to land a man up where it's dry. Is it binding? Goodness, yes. Unbreakable?
Unless?
There is a little something we could try.
Go on.
Yes. Perhaps we could arrange a sort of trade-off. Maybe swap your daughter's soul for, say, your own. Make this deal and set her free, or else she comes with me. To suffer through eternity alone.
It's not my soul you're after, it's my power.
Now which would you rather be? King of the sea? A father to his little girl?
The trident is a great responsibility, Ursula.
Nonsense, Trite-One! Hand it over! Finally, the oceans belong to me! All the magic of the trident and the shell in my control. And now dark shall reign forever over ocean, sea, and shoal. Now see for yourself how banishment feels. You poor, unfortunate soul!
You there!
What's this? A human ship? Choppy! Not anymore!
I won't let you harm her!
No matter. I have what I want, and you don't.
You may have my father's trident, but you'll never have his power.
Impertinent mermaid. I'll dispatch you as easily as I eliminated your mother.
So father was right.
Yes, father was right. And you'll see how insignificant the merfolk will become once I'm in charge. With the trident in hand, I shall unleash the power of Poseidon to destroy you all.
Forgive me?
Well, I've never been prouder. Somehow, in the blink of an eye, when my back was turned, you grew up. You love him very much, don't you?
With all due respect, sir, Ariel is the one who has done the rescuing.
King of the sea? And she's his daughter?
Does that upset you?
Good heavens, no. I'm just relieved she's royalty.
Your Majesty, at last I have found someone who I am eager to seize the future with and claim my birthright as king. But I do hope that if I slip off into the sea sometimes, she'll be there beside me. May I have her hand?
Ariel can speak for herself.
She can?
What would I give to live where you are? What would I pay to stay here beside you? What would I do to see you smiling at me?
Ariel, it's been your voice all along.
Now they can talk. Now they can run. Now they can stay all day in the sun.
Just you.
Thank you.
Jay McCoy. I'm the art teacher here at Westridge. For the last 2 or 3 years, we've been doing the drama here. I've been working on the props, set designs for the play. And we're just going to walk you through a couple of the sketches and some of the color work that kind of leads to the production and the building of the sets. So usually what I do is to start off with some simple line work on paper. And we'll actually do a couple of various sketches, and then we'll get it refined down to a simple line drawing. And the way this helps us in actually making the sets is I will actually take this and put it on laminated plastic, sketch it out in black line, throw it on the overhead, we'll project it up onto the actual building material, trace it out, and that saves a lot of time and a lot of effort and allows us to get more hands involved in the actual artwork. So this kind of helps us as a tool to get it up on the work. What I'm working on right here is a simple little building sketch of how the options would actually get constructed and put together. Here we're just using a sheet of MDF as one of these panels on the edge, and we're actually going to put some lumber between them with another panel, so this actually has a 3D quality to it and actually sticks out from the backboard, which also gives us some stability because now it's now much thicker and can stand up easier. So it's also part of the safety aspect of trying to build the sets. All I'm doing here is showing the great volunteers that are going to be helping build the sets, which are a lot of our parents here at Westridge. Kind of how we're going to use the lumber to kind of brace and provide some structure so that we do have these props nice and safe, and these backdrops nice and safe. How we're going to use the supports, and also I'll also throw some color on here so that a lot of our parents will know which of the paints we're going to be using in certain sections and how it's going to look when we're finished. So this provides a little bit more information, and it allows for different people to be able to look at it, work at different times on different days, which just makes it a lot easier for everybody involved. Because as we said, volunteers, we're very fortunate to have a lot of people that don't mind helping, and this just kind of helps give them a visual idea of what it is we need for the play when we're ready for it. Again, what we have here is a completed rendering of what was one of our set designs to be, how it's constructed, the color scheme, how it's going to be painted. And of course, anything that's left white would just be lumber color, so that kind of lets them know that it doesn't need to be painted because it's not going to be seen. And this way they can kind of get a sense of what the base colors are, and then some of me and a couple other volunteers will come in, do some of the texturing, some of the final touches, and that way we can get more hands involved in the project, which makes the work a little bit easier on everybody.
From Westridge Elementary School, this is Action News. And now let's join our reporter on the scene, Ray Magic Adams.
Hi, I'm Magic Adams from magicadams.com. Currently, I am working on this project, being your lighting manager. Now, there's a couple things that we've added this year that we have never had before. One, we have several more lights, like an aquifer, to make it look like you're underwater. We've also added black lights and something that you're going to be excited about, video. That's right, we're going to have a video projector, projecting video across the actors as they're doing it this year. And after that, there will be a transformation done by yours truly on a green screen. That's something we haven't done before. Now let's go over and see some natural environments. Here's a young lady that's working hard. Let's ask her how she's doing it. How are you doing this?
I'm helping with props.
That's excellent. And is it a very tedious process? Is it kind of difficult for you?
Well, you have to keep the kids quiet.
And that is, of course, the most difficult part. Here we have Bill, who's been doing our audio for quite some time. Now, what is the biggest challenge from this year to from last year?
The biggest challenge is to keep the kids quiet backstage, because kids don't like to be quiet. And a lot of times the mics are on right before they go on, so that's a big challenge. It's like, you got to be quiet, kids, because if not, it's going to come out over the speakers. So.
Now, last year we had quite a bit less microphones than we have this year, right?
Yeah, we've got 14 wireless microphones. So this is the biggest production I've ever done, and it's a little hairy.
And what is your name?
John Caldwell.
John Caldwell. And what part are you playing, John?
Prince Eric.
Prince Eric. That is the one, the male lead, is it not?
Yes.
And has it been hard?
Yes.
What's the hardest, learning your lines or learning the music?
The music.
Are you having fun?
Yeah.
That's what matters. Hey, this is Magic Adams from MagicAdams.com again, and I am here with some more child thespians. And what is your name?
Janae.
And what is your name?
Caitlin Blake.
Caitlin, and what is your name?
Jakyla.
And what role do you all play?
A flamingo.
You play the flamingos? Now, what's the hardest part? Is it standing on one foot, or is it learning the music?
The music.
It's the music. And do you all enjoy being in the costume?
Yeah.
Have you all been in having fun doing this? You're a lily pad, so you're not a flamingo. And you're... See, when I say, when are you a flamingo, and you say, mm-hmm, that means you're a flamingo, okay? So we have a frog, a lily pad, flamingos, and other people here live for the Little Mermaid Project.
Scary watching them.
It is scary watching them?
Stare at you. They're like staring at you. It's hard.
So you are working as hard as you can just to get your lines out, your music out, and dance while you're in front of all those people. All right. What's your name?
Lauren.
And the role that you're playing?
Clownfish.
She's Lauren and she's playing the clownfish. What's your name?
Morton.
And you're playing?
Sailor.
You're playing a sailor. That's awesome. What's your name?
Lane.
And you're playing what?
One of Ursula's evil eels, Flotsam.
You are one of Ursula's evil eels? Awesome. And what's your name?
Yeah.
And what do you play?
Sailor and a chef.
Sailor and a chef. Doing double work here. What's your name?
Emily.
And what do you do?
A lily pad.
You are a lily pad. All right. And what's your name?
My name's Maggie Richardson, and I play a princess and a mer sister.
That's awesome. What's your name?
Haley Jane Martin.
What role do you play?
I play a mer sister and a princess.
Another double show. All right, what's your name?
Hi, my name's Kylie Paige Perry, and I play a mer-sister and a princess.
That's awesome. I love her wig. Just a vibrant colors. What's your name?
Amaya.
And what do you play?
Carlotta.
And what's your name?
Sydney, and I'm a sailor chef.
Caitlin, and I'm a sailor and a chef.
I'm Olivia, and I'm a sailor and chef.
Holy cow, we've got three people, no, four, five, six. We have more than half the cast playing two roles at one time. Eat your heart out, Johnny Depp. What role are you playing?
Grimsby.
And what is your real name?
Henry Hoffman.
Henry Hoffman. Henry Hoffman. Playing Grimsby. That's one of Eric's, you are Eric's advisor, aren't you?
I'm his droll valet.
And so that means that you're basic job for the entire show is to make sure that he gets married at the end of 3 days. Is that right?
Yeah, kind of.
So you really want him to marry a princess, right?
Yeah.
What has been the hardest thing for you thus far? Has it been the music or has it been learning your words?
Learning my words.
Learning your words? And I noticed that you have a lot of old age makeup on. Do you like wearing the makeup?
Sort of.
When I wear the makeup, I love to wear the makeup too when I'm in a show. That's excellent. Does it itch a little bit?
No.
It doesn't itch for you? You are one of the lucky ones, I have to say that. So this is Grimsby, and you can see him in The Little Mermaid. Hey, this is MagicAdams.com reporting for the live for the Little Mermaid Project. And what I have here is I have one of the makeup artists for the show. What is your name?
Brittany Spicer. Miss Spicer, the best fourth grade teacher you ever found.
Miss Spicer, the best fourth grade teacher that you'll ever find. Apparently she's got some support on that statement. I'm sure you do. I'll be liking your Facebook page.
Okay.
So what kind of things have you been doing most difficult?
Well, Sebastian was quite a job. I really had to feign it out from the eyes, jewel it up, and sparkle away. It was great.
Sparkle, oh, I just noticed that I'm sitting in a disco ball. I'm gonna be fabulous, aren't I?
You're gonna be fabulous, jazz hands all around.
So how difficult has this job been? Has it been really hard?
Well, you know, it's been some sleepless nights, and I won't lie, sweat rolling down. But it's what has to be done for the kids, for the sake of the show.
Well, you're hiding it very well. She's glistening like the moon. Do you see that?
Sparkle. Sparkle's the theme, ladies and gentlemen.
You see her eyes, and it's like, oh.
That's right.
Now, have you enjoyed doing this?
I have. It has been a great enjoyment.
So you love doing this?
I love doing this.
So even with the glisten running down her face and the sparkles getting in her eyes, she is dedicated to get the makeup on these kids. Isn't that right?
I persevere for the kids.
And I'm Magic Adams for the Little Mermaid Project. Hi, this is MagicAdams.com for the Little Mermaid Project, and I'm here with some stagehands, some adult stagehands, and what do you do?
I go backstage and get everybody so they can perform.
So you're the one in charge of if they get on stage or not?
Yes.
Even though that's not technically your job?
Yes.
So she's the one taking the blame for the blameless. Great, and what's your name?
Shanna.
Shanna, thank you so much, Shanna. And what do you do?
I have been helping with the makeup, and now I'm going to help with backstage to get the props in off the stage.
So double duty again. So not only do we have some kids doing double duty, but we also have adults doing double duty. And what's your name?
Debbie Webber.
Debbie Webby, thank you so much, Debbie. Wow, that's like a tongue twister of sorts. What's your name?
Shane.
Shane, and what do you do?
I move props in and on stage and off.
So you are also doing a thankless job, something that nobody ever sees you actually doing.
I'm dressed in black and nobody sees me.
I hear you, sir. I hear you. Ladies and gentlemen, these are the people who are behind the scenes working their tushes off for the sake of this show. This is Magic Adams. I'm here with, what's your name?
Joshua Graves.
Joshua Graves. And Josh, what do you do during the show?
I move stuff around. I'm an expert at moving things during different scenes. I mainly focus on the bigger objects, but I just move scenes around from time to time.
So you're the muscle behind every time that there's a set change, any time that there needs to be either the grotto or Ursula's lair needs to be brought out, that's you, right?
Yep.
So if it goes wrong, we're blaming you, right?
Yep.
I didn't say it was your fault. I said we're blaming you.
Okay.
Now, this is yet another one of the people who works behind the scenes, never seen on stage, or at least he's trying not to be seen on stage, and yet does not get thanked because he's working so hard. Thank you so much for your job. Thank you for your participation. And ladies and gentlemen, I'm Magic Adams, and this is the Little Mermaid Project.
Hi, I'm Magic Adams, and I'm here with Ariel from Little Mermaid from Westridge Elementary. What's your real name?
Alexis Billings.
Alexis, and have you had a lot of fun doing this show?
Yes.
What has been the most difficult part? Has it been learning your words, learning your movement, or learning the songs?
My words.
Your words? That's one of the hardest things to do, is to memorize everything that you have to say. Are you having a lot of fun doing the program?
Yes.
And would you do it again next year?
I would most definitely do it next year.
Now, is it kind of hard to do the things that you have to do? Because you also have to sing all of your solos. You have to do all the dances that you're in, which you're in just about every number. And you have to memorize the order in which everything has to be done in. It's a lot of work, isn't it?
Yes.
And it's kind of hard?
Well, no, it is before you are about to do the show.
So you've been working your tush off all the way up till this performance tonight, is that right?
Yes.
So she's been working really hard and she is dedicated to this program. That means we need to keep this going. I'm here behind the scenes with the one, the only Sea Witch, isn't that right?
Yes.
And what is your real name?
Anna Simpson.
And you are playing Ursula in the play, right?
Yes.
Have you been having a lot of fun doing this?
Yes.
Would you do it again?
Probably, yes.
And what is the hardest part? Is it putting on the makeup, getting the makeup put on you? Or is it learning your words, or what?
Probably the stage directions is the hardest part for me.
So learning how, where to move, when to move, has been the most difficult process for you?
Yes.
And you definitely do this again?
Yes.
So you heard it, folks. She has been trying her best and doing her best to do her best on stage. You've been doing a pretty good job so far.
Thank you.
You're going to do an excellent job tonight.
Okay.
Are you excited?
Yes.
She's excited. She's been working really hard, and she can't wait to do it again next year. Hi, ladies and gentlemen. This is Magic Adams reporting live for the Little Mermaid Project, and I am here with, what's your name?
Sarah Blade.
And what part do you play in Little Mermaid?
A turtle.
You play a turtle?
Yes.
You are the fastest moving turtle that I've ever seen. Did you know that?
No.
You've been doing a pretty good job. What's been your hardest part, learning the songs or learning where you need to go?
The song.
You heard it, ladies and gentlemen. They have been working really hard. And would you do it again next year?
Yeah, definitely.
You heard her. She'd definitely do it next year. Crikey, I'm here with the Westridge Elementary children in their natural environment. Look at here. We have Sebastian. What's your real name?
Maddie LeCompte.
And you're playing Sebastian?
Yes.
Are you having fun?
Yes.
Excellent. And you are?
Mason McDonald.
And you play?
Flounder.
You play Flounder. And what's your name?
Logan Thomas.
And you play?
Aquata Ariel's sister.
Hi there. Spotlight guy. Looking forward to the show. It's a great show. The kids have been putting in a lot of effort. And the parents and the staff and the faculty. I'm excited to be part of this.
What's your name?
Vanessa Watkins.
Vanessa Watkins. And what do you play?
Matina, Ariel's sister.
And all of you are Ariel's sisters?
Yes.
Yes.
And don't you also play princesses?
Yes.
Yes. We do.
They have several roles that they're playing, and all for The Little Mermaid. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, and I can't wait to see you guys in the show.
In 3, 2...
Hi, I'm Alexis Billings. I'm in 5th grade. Do you want me to do that again? Did I point her in the wrong direction?
My, isn't that unusual?
Don't tell me she's fond of pipes. Can't say I blame you. That's Nancy from Dusseldorf.
Sorry, old boy, but it looks like your pipe smoked you.
Very amusing, yes. Well, she knows how to make you smile.
Oh, hey guys. Maybe it's just best I leave the acting to the students. They're far much better at that than I am. Well, welcome as we enter our 4th year of the... Scratch. Oh, hey guys. How are you all?
Stop. Okay. Just, yeah, that'll be fine. Cause I, you know, actually the set looks pretty good. You know you're a camera ham, don't you?
Yeah. So bad. Who's in there? Come on. Give me a piece of meat. Not so bad. Big night. Oh, hey guys.
And you are?
Maggie Richardson.
And you play?
Adreno.
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 Adreno. First, it sounded kind of like a pipe cleaning product.
10,000 years of a
tin can will give you such a crick in the neck.
Attention, attention.
We've already talking to you, aren't you?
Yeah, we did, yeah.
All right, so that's when we take off there. Okay?
You want me to get some makeup too? All right, where's some red? I need some.
Hi, this is MagicAdams.com here, reporting live for the little... Hi! Hey, Magic Adams here, reporting live for the Little Mermaid Project. Are you starting again? Okay.
I wanna see, I'm dancing, walking around on those, what do you call them? Oh, feet.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice.
Oh, okay.
We need to be on.
Hi, I'm Ms. Holmes, and I'm the librarian here at Westridge, and I'm one of the co-directors of our school musical.
And I'm Chris, Ms. Start that again. We just had this conversation and I'm
Christmas.
You're my youngest. I'm old enough to take after myself.
Thank you. As long as you live under my roof, you'll obey my rules.
If you just listen to me for once.
That's the last time you're ever swimming to the surface again.
Hi, I'm Ms. Holmes, and I'm the librarian here at Westridge, and I'm also one of the co-directors of our school musical.
I'm Ms. Jones, and I'm the other co-director, as well as the music teacher here at Westridge.
All right, so this process begins usually the year before we start talking about what shows we'd be interested in doing, and we look on the website where we order our shows, and we get some ideas, and we think about the type of students that we have at our school, and what's required in the show, and we come up with a decision, and we try to flip back and forth who gets to decide, and this year I was the decision maker and Little Mermaid it was. So we decided that back at the end of last school year, beginning of the summer, and that led to us at that point deciding how we wanted to audition our kids, and we said since this was a bigger show, a more complex show, that this year we wanted to have some type of workshop to get the kids prepared for what they would be in for if they were to be in production. And we had our first ever audition workshop this past fall before we did our audition.
From there, we had auditions in October. I guess it was Saturday towards the end of October. And we had almost 70 kids audition, which was probably our biggest turnout ever, which was really exciting for us. And the kids were really excited, which makes us even more excited. And then we had our first read-through in December, which got everybody pumped. And from there, we came back from Christmas, and we hit the road running with Tuesday and Wednesday rehearsals. And some kids were here pretty much every week with us.
I guess the good thing about us and our partnership is that we're good at different things.
Right.
So we break things up. I tend to do the business end of everything. And she tends to be the more creative and grab everything.
They come to me and
which works pretty well.
Down to earth, down to life, back to reality.
We make it through without very many bruises.
We're not Broadway.
So we make it work, but yeah, I tend to do the business end of it. She does more of the creative side of it. And then when it comes to the actual performance, I do more of the choreography aspect of it. She does the music, and we kind of both do the drama part of it. So we work together on that. And then
it's a team effort. And we have pretty much our job is done from there, because from there we have all of our wonderful parents that kind of take over from costuming and makeup and lights and sound and video, and it's backstage crew. It's just amazing the amount of people that step forward to help us. And we had to constantly refer to her home, her home sheet. Her spreadsheet.
The home spreadsheet.
Her spreadsheet. Yeah. Which was just full of parents and who are willing to go above and beyond, which is what it takes in order to pull off something like this.
I don't think people realize this is our biggest show. We had over 63 kids in this performance this year. And pretty much every child had someone in their family that helped in some way, whether, like you said, it was with costumes or makeup, chaperoning,
backstage crew,
cast party. I mean, we honestly had an army that helped us. And then you have to add in the teachers and staff here at our building who also helped. And I feel like we did very little after
some
all that
teachers,
said and done.
Our staff, our parents. So they have double duty there. Mm-hmm. But we're very grateful and very thankful for every parent.
It could not be done without them.
I
it would not be done without them.